Respiration part 2. Before watching this video, strongly recommending you to watch the previous one, the part first, then only you get the continuation. In part 2, we are going to discuss about the pulmonary respiration and gas exchange lung level, that is the diffusion of gases, the oxygen and carbon dioxide, adding of oxygen and removal of carbon dioxide. Then the pulmonary circulation and systematic circulation, that is the double circulation. Then transport of gases in blood, the oxygen transport as oxyhemoglobin and carbon dioxide transport as bicarbonate, carbonic acid, carbaminohemoglobin. So we will discuss this in detail. Gas exchange lung level. The exchange of oxygen with the carbon dioxide present in the blood capillaries around the alveoli. So the air enters in the lungs and the exchange of oxygen with the carbon dioxide in the deoxygenated blood, that is coming from the tissues in the blood capillaries around the alveoli. So this pulmonary exchange of respiratory gas is called external respiration. Here there is something special, that is about the pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Generally artery carries oxygenated blood from here to the other organs, and veins carries deoxygenated blood to the heart from the tissues. So oxygenated blood means the blood which contains higher amount of oxygen, and the deoxygenated blood means the blood contains higher amount of carbon dioxide. So in general case, the arteries carry oxygenated blood and the veins carry deoxygenated blood. But in the case of the pulmonary artery, this is the only artery that is carries deoxygenated or impure blood, or blood with a higher carbon dioxide concentration. The pulmonary artery is the only artery that carries deoxygenated or impure blood, and also the pulmonary vein is the only vein that carries oxygenated blood or pure blood. And this circulation is called as pulmonary circulation. The pulmonary circulation is the circulation where the blood is oxygenated. There is another type of circulation, that is systematic circulation, that is between the heart and other organs except lungs. In the systematic circulation, rest of the body provided oxygenated blood. So the oxygen reaches in the tissues for release of energy, that is in the systematic circulation. But in the case of pulmonary circulation, the blood is oxygenated. That means it is a circulation of blood between the heart and the lungs. Deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle of heart is carried to the lungs by pulmonary arteries. So the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle of heart is carried to the lungs by pulmonary arteries, and in alveoli the gas exchange takes place, that means removing carbon dioxide and adding oxygen. Then the oxygenated blood returned to the heart by pulmonary artery. The oxygenated blood from the lungs returned to the heart by pulmonary artery. Pulmonary circulation. This is the heart, which has four chambers: right atria, left atria, right ventricle, left ventricle. So the deoxygenated blood from the tissues reaches the right atria, then to the right ventricle. From right ventricle, this deoxygenated blood or impure blood is carried to the lungs by pulmonary artery. The impure blood pumped to the lungs from the head through the pulmonary artery. So the after the gas exchange in alveoli, the gas exchange adding oxygen and removing carbon dioxide, the oxygenated blood is carried again to the heart by pulmonary vein. So this circulation is called as pulmonary circulation between heart to lungs. So the impure blood first reaches in the right atria, then to the right ventricle, then to the lungs through the pulmonary artery. After gas exchange, the oxygenated blood reaches again to the heart in the left atria, through the pulmonary vein, then to the left ventricle, then to the anterior body. Again, the deoxygenated carbon dioxide reaches the right atria and so on. Then the systematic circulation means the left ventricle. From the left ventricle, the oxygenated blood reaches the anterior organs, and after the metabolic process, the carbon dioxide is released, and that deoxygenated blood is again carried to the right atria. So here the double circulation, the pulmonary circulation and systematic circulation. Transport of gases in blood. So the oxygen is carried by erythrocyte or red blood cells. red blood cells or RBC, which contain a respiratory pigment called as hemoglobin, an iron containing respiratory pigment hemoglobin. So the entire oxygen is transported by hemoglobin. So the oxygen combined with hemoglobin and form oxyhemoglobin. So the oxygen combined with hemoglobin and form oxyhemoglobin. It does not dissociate till reaching the tissues. And in the tissues, the concentration of oxygen is very low. Blood carries oxygen from lungs, so here the higher concentration. So in tissues, after catabolic process, the amount of oxygen is decreased. So here the lower concentration. So the higher concentration to lower concentration, the movement of particle, this is called diffusion. The movement of particle from higher concentration to lower concentration, this is called as diffusion. Diffusion means movement of particle from higher concentration to lower concentration. So here blood there is higher concentration because the oxygen is carried from lungs. And in the tissues there is lower concentration because after catabolic activities. So the diffusion takes place. So the oxygen moves from blood to the tissues. And in the case of carbon dioxide, the reversal. After catabolic activities, the concentration of carbon dioxide is higher in tissues. So after catabolic activity, the concentration of carbon dioxide is higher in tissues. And also in the blood vessels, the concentration of carbon dioxide is lower than the tissues. So here also diffusion from higher concentration to lower concentration. In the case of carbon dioxide, the process is reversed. In tissues, the concentration of carbon dioxide is higher than blood because after catabolic activities, the concentration of carbon dioxide in tissues is higher than blood. So here the higher concentration, here the lower concentration. So after diffusion, carbon dioxide moves from tissues to the blood, from higher concentration to lower concentration. Transportation of CO2, the next. In tissue, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is higher than blood. So the carbon dioxide reaches in the blood from tissues through diffusion, through the tissue fluid or lymph. And the transportation of carbon dioxide through blood takes place in different ways. The first case, a small amount of carbon dioxide dissolved in plasma and form aqueous solution. This is the first case. And in the second case, through erythrocytes. Some amount of the carbon dioxide combined with the globin, that is the part of the reduced hemoglobin, so also called as deoxyhemoglobin, to form an unstable compound. This is called as carbaminohemoglobin. So the carbon dioxide combined with the deoxyhemoglobin to form carbaminohemoglobin. Carbon dioxide plus deoxyhemoglobin, carbaminohemoglobin. This is the case 2. And in the case 3, is bicarbonate in plasma as well as in erythrocytes. Here the carbon dioxide combined with the water to form carbonic acids, and after this carbonic acid dissociate into bicarbonate. In erythrocyte there is an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase which acting as a catalyst, but this enzyme is absent in plasma. This is present only in erythrocytes, the carbonic anhydrase which catalyzes the reaction, that is the formation of carbonic acid. So there are three cases. First one, a small amount dissolved in plasma. Second, the carbon dioxide in erythrocyte combined with the deoxyhemoglobin and carbaminohemoglobin. And is bicarbonate in plasma as well as in erythrocytes. In plasma, the carbonic anhydrase, the enzyme is absent. But in erythrocyte, the zinc containing enzyme, the carbonic anhydrase, catalyzes the reaction, the formation of carbonic acid. The formation of carbonic acid is higher in erythrocyte than plasma. What is the reason? In erythrocyte, there is an enzyme, carbonic anhydrase, which catalyzes the entire reaction, the formation of carbonic acid. So, the formation of carbonic acid is higher in erythrocytes than plasma. In next video, we will discuss the reaction inside the cell, the release of energy, and the tidal volume and the residual volume, vital capacity, respiratory disorders, mounting sickness, carbon monoxide poisoning, and occupational disease.